It is getting powered by World Sports Betting. Mamelodi Sundowns 1, SuperSport United 0 in the DStv Premiership. We also have a website. It's called Itiski Times. You can go to itiskitimes.co.za. There are around 1 million or 2 visitors on that website every month. So thank you very much for the support there. Very competitive football match. Very happy. You and I were very happy just to see him. And it was tactically stimulating. You know, when Kevin Hunt tells his players that just sit at the center, only start pressing when the ball gets to the center. Because when you press them on their D-line, you're opening up spaces behind you and then they will easily locate their man behind you. That was the first thing you noticed. The second thing you noticed was that inverted wingers. Thapelo Maseko on the right instead of on the left, Kampane Lungu on the left instead of on the right, so that gives them an opportunity to cut in and take shots, if they want to take shots. It confuses the wing backs in terms of, what is my standing position when this guy has the ball? Do I look to my left or look to my right? Is it taking the byline or is it cutting inside? Those were tactically stimulating things that we saw. There was a penalty incident. The Thapelo Maseko hits the post as well. It was a very stimulating game. A lot of the matches, the Sundowns, are boring because you know what's going to happen. They're defensive, and then after 20 minutes, 30 minutes, they get tired, and Sundowns win. But today, this was different. Although it's a lose, it was different because it was competitive. It was a good football product, an entertaining football match. What did you make of the game, sir?
Mr. Kiwong, Bulisa, when I'm fit, Bulisa Justice, Bulisa Junior, and Bulisa and Nemaka, can support and shall like this. So, be enjoying Jalang Chicken Food.
Yes, sir.
What a game.
Yes, sir.
What a game, Mr. Kiw. You know, when I rewind myself in my mind and thinking of the other games that the Sundowns were playing, mm-hmm. and you know, come fast forward to this game, there was a huge difference. And if you can ask Sundowns now ourselves, they will tell you it was not an easy game tonight.
So the challenge for
them. Yeah, definitely. This is what I always say. Don't make it easier for them. Yes, Sundowns don't win. They're going to win the game, they'll score maybe 1 or 2 goals, whatever the case may be. But make them work for that goal. Make them work for that 3 points. Don't make it easy, because most of these teams, when they play against Sundowns, they sit. And when they sit, you know, it's for me, when you sit, and again, when you're sitting like that, they still get receiving balls in the Zaguma pockets. Then you ask yourself, they'll get them up along my pockets again. Then
the other thing too is that you cannot mark a third man run.
No.
So as you and I are passing the ball, if there's someone on the blind side making a run, yeah, the only thing you could do if you're close to them is to obstruct them.
Yeah.
But you can't. You never know when does it start that run.
Yeah, Mr. Kiw, you know, Sundowns, they strong. These guys are good. Well done to the technical team, Sundowns. They always put on the way of playing, the way they create chances, ama runs of the ball, ama runs to the pockets, because that's one thing that is always killing these teams. They realize ukuthi Sundowns, they don't play in positioning play. They play in pockets. So it means when they play in pockets, they confuse you as an opponent to move away from that position. Then when you move away from that position, then they capitalize on that spot, because when you receive the ball, he's going to receive the ball going to that position that actor was a good. So, look, SuperSport, well done, Coach Kevin. Look, you've won the first leg, and I believe, you know, even today, you know, I even said I hope it's going to be a draw because of that penalty. You know, a penalty, yes, we'll never know. I think it would be a penalty, bangai kora or bangai misa. But, you know, the main fact of what it was supposed to be a penalty, then something else. Then the chances, look at this boy, Maseko, Oshai Ilonjan upright lapana. It's, you know, Mr. Ngewo, one thing I was so impressed with Kevin when they were attacking was a good thing. He had Ulungu, he had Lomfana lo on the right Maseko. Uguti goalkeeper Magatola Magaba Isan as my attack Magabambi ball. He knew. He knew Guti I've got Ulontuzanangale. Then he played. Because you know why? That's one thing that I said, and I hope maybe Nibo needed Nonk. Today, Sundowns, they didn't initiate the attack using Umutawa and Umutiba. They didn't. And today they were more sitting than the normal player, but where you'll find them, Ulapanagui, center line, Umutawa and Umutiba, center line. And they were sitting here because of Babo Nilugutino Ukavin says, it's fine, hit me, but I'll hit you. Stay there and stay there, I'll wait. When I get a ball, one way or another, if he has a goal, goalkeeper will bam, then I'll play a transition.
This is also the time where you wish he had better players. Sundowns has Ronan Williams from SuperSport, Tebogo Mokoena from SuperSport, Sipho Mbula from SuperSport, and Aubrey Modiba from SuperSport. Now, of course, SuperSport needs to decide what they do with that money because it's a sale. No one stole those players. But these are the kind of moments where you wish that there was an equal quality on both sides because this game was on another level tactically and Sundowns were really challenged today.
Look, it's only pound to pound that let SuperSport down because at some point they couldn't match. Sundowns players, you know, 1v1, they'll take you on. You know, the individual brilliance, they're very smart, the clinical in dribbling, you know, the passing, the movement. So, yeah, man, you know, Mr. Ngeo, Joba Oshoma, if those players were there, it was going to be a total different ball game.
More competitive.
I'm telling you, it was very, I want to make it more competitive. Really, I agree with you because if you can watch now, it was competitive even now. But when you look at the individual brilliance of those players and then looking at the way great that SuperSport they're having, I'm telling you, it was going to be something else.
Yeah. But who's so a resurrected player?
This
performance was so immense. Wow. One thing that you dislike about PSL is the lack of consistency.
Yeah.
If he becomes this, he reminds us of the player that he was at Maritzburg United.
Yeah.
Just talk about his performance. What did he do right at number 6 today?
Wow, Mr. Kew, this boy, I think he needed a coach that will believe in, also believe in Aguye, and give him that confidence and say, go in there, do what you can do best. And he did very well. The only thing that I was worried about is when sometimes they receive the ball, it takes time to take decisions.
Mm.
And now Sundowns players, when they attack, they've got numbers when they attack. And immediately when they lose the ball, they close down quick. So that's where I was worried. But when it comes to his work rate in that midfield, you know, closing down the spaces, winning the ball and pass, look, he did very well. And Ugiyagwako SuperSport, I think it was maybe I would say in your shower and Geneguyo, I'm feeling something different because he's doing very well. And I'm very happy to see, you know, when you see a player, the way Konago Pirates, the way games where you could see good, man, there is something good about this boy. But Utambeka next game, Uzodlali right back next game, Udlali midfield next game, Udlali wing. So you get confused, and then I myself am confused. But now we do Gavin, I think he puts him in that position, and that position suits him very well, and he did very well tonight.
There you go, that's SuperSport United, Mamelodi Sundowns winning. You would wonder, of course, if you were affected by load shedding, what changed? Why are you suddenly happy about this one? Because it's the same win for Sundowns. But really, I would hope that if you had an opportunity, I know it's load shedding and power cuts throughout the country. If you had an opportunity, you would have seen for yourself that this was a more competitive game. Yes, it doesn't help anyone that the league is already won by this point. It's not an entertaining football product if a team wins the league in January. In fact, if it wasn't for a World Cup, by December it would have been all over. You know, it doesn't help anyone. It's not about hating or whatever. It's a good football product. We're looking at Arsenal now and we're like, in 19 matches, they have an 8-point lead. Can they carry it to game number 38? That's stimulating. That's a good football product. It means that you can hang in there and watch until the end. Now, in South African football, it ends within January. What are we going to talk about in February, in March, April?
You know, by the time we get to May, we already know who won. You know, so we do need, of course, this is not Sundowns' fault as well. They win because they win and they do what they have to do. You know, collect the prize money, 15 million rands per year. Every time you win the league, you go and have an assault at the CAF Champions League. You know, they do what they have to do. You run your own race. If no one else is catching up, that's everyone else's fault. I'm just saying, as a football product, it's much better, much, much, much better when it's competitive that we get to May and we don't know who's going to win. Today was those kind of matches. Although Sundowns won, it was stimulating to watch. It was beautiful to watch because they were given a challenge. They were given questions, and some of the questions they failed to answer. It was a matter of the referee, it was a matter of the crossbar. They should have at least scored two goals, the SuperSport United, and Sundowns on the other side should have at least scored two goals too, as well. If you think about the chances that Sereno got, and Lutemba Zwane almost missing a tap in, they're almost scoring a tap in, you know. So this was a very beautiful game of football. In case you didn't watch it and you're looking at the final results and you're thinking, what are we on about, it was a beautiful game of football, just at a level of its competitive nature. It is KTV, it is KTimes, World Sports Betting. Thank you very much for watching us.